Well, good day, conductors and engineers. Welcome back to Train Sim Sunday. Well, through the week here, I've been playing a little bit, and I actually got us a brand new, I know we haven't seen everything all together yet, anyways, a brand new district or area or whatever you call it, called Canadian Mountain Passes. And it's pretty cool. Now, I don't exactly want to start a career yet. Careers are quite somewhat difficult, like this one here is, you know, pretty crazy. But, what about just standard? Is there standard missions? Oh, there may not be. There is not Canadian Mountain Pass. Oh, really? Well, we could do free roam. There's those. They're just kind of, I guess they're okay too. Careers and stuff are a lot more difficult. You gotta really, you know, watch signals, and you know, I haven't really played it enough to get right up onto that quite yet. So, difficulty's only 2, so I guess we'll start that. Now, the scenery is pretty nice. There's a lot of trees, of course. If you like trees, well, this is perfect. Trees and railway track. Mountains and stuff. And extraordinarily long, really long trains. Apparently they take 700 cars at a time. Well, not that many, but at least 200 cars at a time. All depending on what you want to do. So you can see how long these trains are. This one on the left has got a train in the middle and it's still going. I don't know if I want to take a train that long. That's really long, and I'm zipping past here really fast. That's fantastically long. I think we're going to take this train on in the middle here. Because these ones are like, they're all the same car. But you know, it's kind of boring-ish. However, what I am going to do is so what we're going to do is, let's go up high here, we're going to take control of this train. I actually want to put these two engines on the back of this one we're going to use here. So we got to make sure, hang on a sec here, got to push the wrong buttons. Wow, it's really super, that's right. Doing the right one, hang on, okay, gotta zoom out. Hit the world one there, there we go. Make sure that our track is set. Which right now it's not. Okay, so we're gonna roll out. We're going to back into these engines and put these ones on the back. So we have a little bit extra pushing power. Well, that's three, five engines, I guess. I don't think there's anything in the middle of this one. Should have changed the time of the day on this because it's a little shadowy right now, but we'll get the idea, I guess. Kind of a weird engine or a horn on this engine. It turns the bell on too whenever you use it, so remember to turn that off every time. It's neat because I got some Canada cars too, eh? I like that, that's neat. Even this train's long enough, it's still coming out of the sidings here. Some Canadian Pacific Railway cars. These all have like automobiles in them. They have a great big Honda plant in Alliston, Ontario, which is about 35-40 minutes from me. They have all kinds of those kind of cars all around there. Same with the Toyota over in Cambridge. They have all kinds of those there too. Losing a bit of speed, we're going uphill here a little bit, right? So there's a 0.6% grade we're going up. So yeah, we'll hook those other guys on, and then these ones will be actually hooked too. I don't want to take them with me though, that's just way too long. Could take these cars with us on our left side, but I think we'll just go with what we've got here. Hook those engines on and then go with that. So let's go up high for a minute. You see some of this beautiful scenery. Rivers and stuff. It's probably the Trans-Canada Highway. Lots of scenery. Huge big mountains and stuff in the way off in the distance. I don't think I can actually go to them. Holy cow, I can pretty much. That's neat, eh? Okay, so we're coming to the end here, so I'll apply some brakes. Make sure that changed over. Yeah. Looks good. Alright, let's go down where we're gonna hook on here. Put it in reverse. A little bit of power. The brakes off. We're not gonna need much power because she's gonna roll downhill, of course. So we're going to have to really be tender on the brakes. I'm not sure why these are running. They don't usually run until you hook onto them or whatever, but slow down a little bit. It's funny, it says zero, but it's still moving. Very inconsistent there, isn't it? So this will be a tricky kind of hookup here. Might just save that just before something there happens. I've seen it before where it's like, what the heck, I guess the train's so long, it's moving at the front, but all the play between the couplers, it's like bang, 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 and all of a sudden you're going like 20 at the back here. It's like I'm going that speed, but I'm going the wrong way. Doing 6.5 kilometers, that doesn't make any sense. As long as she creeps back, there we go. See how that all of a sudden takes right off? Well, we didn't derail her though. Sometimes that'll derail on you. Okay, let's go and couple these. Put her forward. We'll give her lots of power. Oh, that's still coming back. The brakes are on 100%. That's crazy. That stays decoupled there. Never seen that before. And we're not moving at all. There we go. Going on here. I think it's having a little freak out. It still thinks I'm hooked to those trains where I'm not. Okay, we're going to have to manually go back here and see what's going on. Because we are not hooked to those trains. I am 100% sure of that. Now we're not. That was really odd. I guess it must have hooked up on me again there or something. Okay, now we gotta look at our route. Which way are we going here? So we're heading this way. I'm not too sure if that's the way I wanted to go. Yes, it is. Okay. There's a really neat little system here. It goes through a mountain. It'll take us a minute or two to get there. But you'll really enjoy this when we get to it. I don't think we're gonna probably go too much further than that, because you can see this is a really long route. Like, this would take us about 4 hours to explore all this. It's just massive, huge, long. Like, to get from where we are way over here, pretty much the one end, to way over here would probably be about a 4 hour drive. So I wouldn't mind maybe doing these little weird screwy little thingies here and then maybe coming to this bend here. I don't know if this is what this is. It's a pretty sharp bend though. Looks like a nose. So we're on the way. A couple of neat little turns. And this is pretty cool here, so. Get it up to 50 anyways. Gotta stay out a bit because it's not so loud right by the engines. If it's inside, it's really loud. Plus out here you can see some nice scenery. Nice lakes, rivers and stuff. Got time it does a little twitchy, buggy thingy. So fairly heavy train, I guess. Lots of cargo in this. So what I'm gonna do is really tough on my computer, actually, this game. I've got the settings up for as high as I'll go, so it's nice for you guys, but the odd time it does give a little bit of a twitch, I will say. A lot of trees and stuff to draw, right? So just flying. Yeah, this dirt strain itself here is pretty long. Gone. Going 7 kilometers over the speed limit, which not good. They do count that as your score, so, but sometimes it's hard to keep her at that exact speed limit. Plus we also got places to go, things to do, and things to see. So in a career mode you'd want to be a little more particular to that though. So that's the Eldon Lake Louise portal. Oh, okay. Imagine how many hours, I guess you would calculate it as hours, it would take to, for them to originally have run all these tracks. Holy jumping. Way, 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 way back, you know. Close to the road here. I wonder if we're going to do a crossover soon or something here. Right close. Whoa, that really bugged out there. Woo! I'll be able to go so far ahead here too. Oh yeah, that's as far as I can go. Let's sit on the hill here like we were camping or something. We can watch the train go by somewhere here. Yeah, right about here. So we're sitting here enjoying the nice scenery, maybe having a swamwich or something. Don't hear any train yet. Watch behind for bear attacks. In the middle of nowhere here. Be lots of black bear and grizzly bear and stuff. Oh, I can hear something. There's something coming down the tracks. Oh, it's actually 40 here. Oops. Cut her down. We're just past a 40 zone. They're coming up to a curve here, I guess. So let's just have a quick look. Oh, yeah, we're into the curve now. There's a train coming, Fred! It's funny, you watch the trees, they all turn with me. Is he coming? Or not? Holy cow! Oh, he's getting close, I can hear him now. There it is! There's the train! Quick, let's run down the hill and see the train. It's actually the curve one here right now, I guess. Oh no, we're past the curve. We're up here somewhere. We're about the middle of the train, so right on. Yeah, we're on a bit of a curve here, I guess. There he goes. Yeah, let's go for a ride. I gotta draw the scenery again. There we go. I must say, built this up, eh? I bet you there's places like that too. Just, oh. Tons and tons and tons and tons and some more tons of gravel have to come in for this kind of stuff to keep it level, eh? That's just crazy. I guess they could have built a bridge through here, but then there's a lot more maintenance with wood and stuff and gravel. Gravel, you just throw a bit more down and she's good forever. Let's have a look. We got any more turns coming up, really? Oh, there's a bit of a yard coming up. Looks like it's going to take us to the left. Let's go to the right. It'll join us back over here anyways. Actually, you know what? We better stick to the left. We haven't gone past it yet. Just because I don't know which way the tracks down there are going to be set up as. Still that 0.6% grade we're going up. Oh, here's a bridge. And another bridge going over water after this, it looks like. Little town. This would be Lake Louise or whatever it was saying there. Now we're really speeding. Ooh. So we could technically stop here, unhook our two trains right about here, engines on the back, back some cars in there, unhook the cars, and then come back and hook up and take off again, but that's okay. We'll just keep motoring. Pick up passengers too if you needed to. Where are the express trains? Or we're just gonna whip on through. coming up soon. Okay. Don't crash. I should probably do a save. Once we get through all that, we don't have too much more to go until these cool turns. But I better do a save here just in case. Track's quite a bit higher here than the one we're on. That's neat. Oh, nice bridge to go over. A little bit of water here. There's another bridge, it looked like, over here, too. Over the road. Steam into her here. Should be able to take corners with this train going at least 45. Actually, probably more like 50 should be fine. Time you get a little glitch there, right? I don't know if it's changing between scenes or something, or what it's doing there. Oh, 1.1% grade now. It's quite a bit steeper. Oh, 1.4 now. Ooh. Oh, 1.1. What? Okay. That's quite a grade though, 1.1%. Doesn't sound like much, but pulling big weights up a hill like that, that's a lot. And trying to brake coming down a hill like that with big weights behind you, that's a lot too. Track coming towards us here now. Higher, of course. Looks like we're flying the drone, eh? There we go, flying the drone. Pull over the track, so we'd be going kind of sideways, now completely backwards, and then we'll just hover. And we'll spin around, And then we'll all start flying forwards. Really fast. Ooh, 1.8% grade now. Ooh, it's steep. Okay, we look at the map here. Everything's set right. Got a bit of a twisty turn coming up here, so we'll bring her down just a little bit, let her coast. Lose a bit of speed. Not by much now, though. Should be able to handle that speed. Oh, look, we're going to go over a big train bridge here. Let's get up there in time. Whoa, almost got hit by a car. More tracks coming up. Sweet. Oh, it levels off here too, so we'll have to start backing off on our speed. Our power. Grade. Now, if you wonder where I'm finding that, right here, follow the cursor of the mouse right down here. The corner shows you how much grade you're on. So eventually this should go back to zero for a split second, and it looks like it goes down after that. Now we're at zero now, so. Also having a lot of problem playing all the, frames per second there was getting pretty low coming over that water. 20. Okay, so it looks like we're going to be heading downhill here again. We want to slow down a lot, apparently. Start her now while we're on the higher ground. Dynamic braking on here, maybe. Find that happy medium where it would just hold itself back. Now we're going down 1.2% grade. think definitely having that extra power, though, made a big difference for us getting up the hill there. Okay, let's let him coast for a bit. We should be getting a little bit closer here. Yeah, a little bit more to go, and then we'll get into these weird turn things. I missed that one. Right next to the highway, that's kind of neat. Oh, that guy just made a lane change, that was cool. I was coming back over. I was going back over again. What the heck's he doing? And he's gonna pass that guy now, I guess. Wow, that was quite the move. There's a nice big lake. Is there a name for that lake? Nameless, I guess. Good size lake, though. It's funny, it seems to be drawn out okay. Speeding, I know. Gotta get there though, right? Safely, we haven't crashed yet, so we should do another save. I could probably go through these turns at around 50 easily anyways, but just to save any problems, we'll just keep her going. Keep her going in around here somewhere, we're 10 over, so. Turn expense off. There's a break. Somewhere here. There's a controller for that. Flip these guys up. Oh, just like that. There we go. ~2.1% downgrade here. Ooh, better get some brakes on. Oh, wrong brakes. Oops. have a look on the map where we are. Coming up here to... Got a split off here for some reason, then we're into our big turns. Oh, this is kind of neat. You guys will probably enjoy this. Hopefully. Wow, that got away on me fast. Better slow that up a bit. Started free running pretty quick there. Okay, so you notice there's a track down there on the map. Shows the track down there. How on earth did we get down that far? Let's have a look at... maps here. So, we're way up top here right now. Oh, don't crash on me. So we're way up top. Somehow we got to get ourselves way down here. Before I stop the train, we better take some of the brakes off now. She's pretty much stopped. Okay, a bit more power. So yes, our objective is somehow to get our train down below the road down there, which is a long way down. Eventually we'll have to end up over there somewhere, I think it is. So, how the heck are we going to do that? Can't jump, that's for sure. Somehow we got to get ourselves down lower. You can't just make a track go straight down the hill. That's not going to work. So I imagine there was a lot of thought had to go into this way, way, way back when they were building the actual train tracks to figure out, okay, we got to get turned and go this way, but how are we going to get down this huge grade? So, here we go. We are going to go outside. We are going to enter this tunnel into the mountain. Jumpy. So we're entering into the mountain and we're still not slowing down. That is crazy. I have no idea why we're not slowing down. We're gaining more speed. I don't like that too much. Something's not going on. Something's not right here. But anyways, here we come out this train, out this tunnel here. Now we're losing some speed. Wowee, that was full brake on there, and she's still gaining speed. So, there we go. That goes through the mountain, does a big loop, drops a bunch, and comes out this side. So now we'll ride in the train. There's another one we gotta do. Coming up here. 50% grade now. We're going down fast. That would really be a challenge going up. As we, for some reason, pretty much stop dead. This is a weird train, I must say. We're at full power here. Now we got no brakes on. But she's not going. Sliding. There, finally go. Maybe it does take that long for the brakes to release, I don't know. Definitely strange train. Brakes don't seem great. Like, I got 58% brake on here and still gaining speed like crazy. Still 79%. There, 92%. Started to slow down a little bit. Still gaining speed though. Dynamic should help hold it back. Slowly losing a bit of speed here now. Let's try the normal brakes. There we go. I was on the wrong one. My bad. Oh man, that's a really long way up. So then all of a sudden you lose all your speed off. It's definitely a strange operation of this train. The other ones on the game don't seem this bad. They actually respond pretty good to your control inputs. This one's very slow. Everything's really slow coming on as power and brakes and everything's really slow releasing. Okay, so here is our next tunnel or loop to get us down lower. We're going to do this one in cab. We're dropping 1.6% here. That's a pretty good drop. Dark. Whereabouts are we? Should be up here. just coming to the straight and popping up. Let's just see the end of the tunnel right there. So that's kind of cool. So our butt should be up there. Yeah, there it is. Just going through. We're just coming out. That's kind of cool, eh? That's how you get down a real big incline or decline, I guess it is. Still going down here. Alright, so our next objective is to get to that big curve, which is... It's still quite a piece of ways, really. It's not too bad when you zoom out like that, but... Still far enough. We might maybe only go to... Maybe this yard or something. I'm just going to go out of the game for a second here and see how the time looks here. Hang on a sec. Yeah, we're at 53 minutes now, so maybe we'll just go down to this yard and continue on another day to that other big turn. I'd like to do the whole route eventually, but that is like a long time. Like, we're up here right now. We still got to drive all the way down here. That's probably going to be another 30 minutes anyways. And then from here to this next yard is probably another 35, 40 minutes or so. And then, holy cow, we still got to... That's a long route. So let's see here. We started here. We're to here. We're 53 minutes. Here... Probably here's another hour. Here to probably up here's another hour. So that's 3 hours. 4 hours. 5 hours. 6 hours. Probably 7 hours of actual gameplay. Now if I unhook these trains and just did the train itself, I could probably go quite a bit faster, but to get from one end to the other and then back again will be 14 hours of gameplay roughly. That's crazy. Make little rock shelter tunnels here too. I think maybe we'll just go to that yard and stop there today, and then we'll continue on another day, because that's going to be crazy. It's amazing how huge some of these levels are. Maps, I guess we'll call them. Routes, probably be the best way. Oh, we're twice and a little bit more faster than we should be, so we better slow up a little bit. Oh, it's handling it pretty good. Oh, I know what we can do. Shut her off. Oh, that's much quieter. We really don't need engine to go downhill and brakes, I guess. That's about all we need. But I like the sound of some of them, how they start. Restart. Okay, let's do a restart. Oh, this one wasn't as good. What's the name of this yard we're going to here? Field siding, I guess. Field depot. And I presume it would take us on this main straightaway through here. Let's see. Now I'm confused. I don't know which way is which here. That's a dark line. I would say that would be the active line. So that should be the active line to bring us right through, I would have thought. But we're going to stop down here anyway, so I better get some more brakes on. She gets away on you. See our little meter here, though. She's getting over to the red. It's a little bit fast in the corners. I just imagine, I guess that's why they have the dynamic braking, which reverses the power to the wheels. If you kept your brakes on all the way down this hill, they'd just smoke right off. I'm sure they would. Yeah, we'll park her at Field here. We'll take off from Field next time and check out that corner. I don't really know if there was... See what I mean? This is going to stop right dead before it gets going here again. I don't really know if there was anything else along here I really wanted to look at, but... Just basic bends and curves and turns and stuff here. Y turn. Oh, there's another yard here or something. Stopped right dead. What the heck? It's like you hit brakes, you hit too much brakes, and it just locks it on until it actually stops you, even though you release the brakes again. Going downhill here, it should hook up and start going pretty quick, you would have thought. It's a very delayed reaction train, it seems. Which you wouldn't think would, if the train actually operates like that, it wouldn't be very safe. Well, I got a break like 2,000 miles before I want to actually stop, but then it keeps stopping until I'm right stop. Like, it's kind of stupid. I got 75% power on here and it's just barely creeping. Going down a 2.2% grade with no brakes on anywhere. That one's on. Now why is that one on? I never touched that one. Maybe that does it if I do that. I don't know. There's strange things happening here. All brakes are off. Or we're going downhill and still losing speed. I don't know. Okay, let's just stop here. What the heck's going on? Now, if it starts rolling backwards... starts rolling backwards, I'd really be concerned. Brakes take forever to actually release. Like 38% power now and it's not doing anything. There, it just released. You hear that? Wow, those are needing some service maybe. I don't know. That's crazy. As far as I know, there's no other trains that act like that in this game. I wish I could switch out the trains. I probably could. I'd have to restart the route again, though. So now we're going, like, super crazy. Coming up to this is where we're going to get out here. Nice little town of Field. There is no fields around here anywhere. And I didn't just toot when I went across the signal there. Oops. I know what we should do. We'll just keep going here and just juice her and see how much speed we can take in the corners. I will save it here though. Do our last save here and then we'll just juice her and see what happens. See how far we get. Much speed we can take until she just rolls off the track. Okay, so let's just put 100% brake on. Emergency brake, but she still goes flying past. I know it's got to take a long time to stop, but it's a lot of weight you're trying to slow down there. Okay, close enough. Let's do a save. Yes. Oh, now we do have to wait till it fully stops because everything's locked on now. Okay, we'll just juice her. Let's do one more save right where we are there. Just juice her and then we'll see how much stress the train can take. Hit some of these corners coming up here. She finally released. Leave the sander on. Oh, what? What? It already crashed. Wait a minute. What's going on there? Consist tilt. Okay. Well, I guess that's the end of that. Okay. Should be able to resume that. I wonder why it... What's a consist tilt? It wasn't even moving, hardly. Wow, that's a weird one. This game is weird like that, I found. You'll all of a sudden crash, and it's like... I wasn't doing anything. Let's just tour here a little bit and see... Might have derailed on the back trains, maybe there. It's too fast for going over those the switch there. Oops. Oops. I don't want that one. Whoa. It's a fairly long train, eh? Forgot how long it was. Okay, she went over there fine, so let's just get her back to the back to our main here. And we'll pour the power to her and see how far she can get. Maybe it'll just derail it instantly again. I don't know. try to get some nice screenshots here. Lose your HUD stuff here, just press F4. F4, F5, F3 shrinks it down, but I kind of like the full thing up. Hopefully, this is set right. There, that's set right now. Once that blue line goes straight through. Alright, so I presume the way we're still heading here, we should still be going downhill. Wasn't really much of a switch there, so I think we could probably juice the power to her now. Let's see how much we can take here. We're already 30 or 10K over. Catastrophic failure, and the train just goes all over the place. Yeah, we're pushing her pretty hard now. Ooh, she's right to the red. It's not going to take too much of this. Right up here so we can watch. 50 or 30 over now. Oh, goodness. Oh, right to the red. Boom! Can't believe it's holding on so far. Oh, she's gonna lose it in this corner here. Mile an hour. 40 more than we should be. Doesn't look all that fast though, does it? I'd laugh if we actually made her down to that bend I wanted to look at. That would probably be where we lose it. Oh, she was leaning a bit there. 71 mile an hour. So they There might be a little bit of a straightaway here right now. Where are we? Yeah, there is. All these turns we're going to probably lose it on. Wow, I can't believe it's holding on. That's insane. Construction site, sweet. Oh, she's gonna go spilling over the edge. Wow, still holding on. We're doing 75.8, almost 76. 76. There she goes, she let go. Well, that was pathetic. What the heck? Just the one fell off. I wanted the rest of them to all go off. Consistent tilt. That's interesting. But anyways, I guess that's it for today. We didn't make her, so... next week, I don't know what we'll do. We'll try to maybe get down to that... either a curve, see what it looks like. Somewhere in here, there's this great big rail bridge. I don't know if it's there or what, but... it'd be nice if I could actually change... what train I can use. I think I can. Let's just quickly try. Oh no, that's going to not do that on me. So I want to use that train, but I want to use it in Canadian Mountain Passes. I don't think it's going to let me. Can only use those trains, I guess. Which is really kind of stupid, because free roam, you think you'd be able to do whatever you wanted. Career quick drive. Maybe quick drive. Canadian Mountain Passes, but I want to use this guy. Oh, okay. We're just gonna have to try that. Hang on a sec before we go. Actually, I don't think that's going to work because it's an electric train. With I think it needs the power from above. That may not work. I'm pretty sure that won't work. Let's see here. Yeah, it doesn't like that. Doesn't like that one. Okay, so quick drive. We'll have to pick. Amtrak. What else we got here? We got a few. That's a weird looking one. Steam train. Oh, this is like the GO train, commuter rails. Canadian Mountain Passes. Six cars. Okay, let's just start this one. I'll show you these ones. They're kind of neat. Our transit system down in Toronto and stuff, called the GO train. This is same engine as they are. Not the same color though, but. Now the new trains are getting down there now, though they're a lot different looking. This is the older style. Haven't been able to find the newer style yet. It's more streamy line looking. All right, we got 2, 3, 4, lots of them. Better turn that back on. Just want to fire it up here. All right. She makes some fast power, I'll tell you. So there's the passenger part. Oh, we got some other cargo too. I didn't realize that. Some truck trailers on flatbeds. And some more trains. Lots of trains, apparently. I think we're actually going the wrong way, the other way, but that's okay. We weren't really going to drive this one. We're just having a look at her. Oh, we'll be crashed before this first corner anyways. Oh, yeah, there's the other way. Well, we could do this. See how a real train responds. Stop before we hit the switch, even. This one sounds really neat, too. I like the sound of this one. And it's fast. Wicked fast. Man, there's a lot of train cars here, isn't there? Holy cow. Still gaining speed. Just flying through, eh? Okay, let's do, where we are actually derailed. Oh, this is gonna screw us right here. I'm going way too fast for this. Way too fast. Yeah. Although it derailed up here. I don't understand. But there you go. Derailment due to junction switching. Oh, yeah, so they had problems there. But anyways, that is it for Train Sim Sunday. Thanks again for watching. Maybe actually next time we'll take this one. Pardon me, it works a little bit nicer. So have a good day. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you next time.